Hello, everyone. My name is Stefan Ivanovic. We're back again for another episode of Go With The Flow, a global watercolour conversation. We're here in Group 21, another fantastic group of fabulous watercolourists from around the globe. And I will just get straight to it. We have a group led by Angela Barbie, Andy Evanson, assisting host, Tere Lojero, David Vialva, Cesc Fare, and Silvia Monge. And well, if we can now go to Angela.
Perfect pronunciation. It's 100 times, million times better than my Polish.
Please, Angela, all yours.
Yes. Okay. Thank you and welcome all to this new episode or session of this Go With The Flow, the Global Watercolor Conversation. We are very excited to be sharing with you this time, and we decided that Jorge Corpuna was going to start, but he's not here. So we can start with maybe Silvia. Remember that you were ready to start yesterday. So we would like to see your works, and we would like you to speak about yourself. She's from Costa Rica and San Jose. She's a fantastic watercolorist, but also she works with glass. So she will tell us all about it. Thank you, Silvia.
Hello, I'm so glad to be here today. Thank you, Stefan, for inviting me and for organizing this event. I'm glad to meet Andy also, because I know you, I know your work. But it's the first time that we have the chance to meet. And very happy to be with Cez, Angela, Tere, and David. I start everything or
yes.
Just presentation?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, whatever you like. Oh, look, Nicolas is going in.
Okay. I love watercolor. I do many medias, but definitely this is the one that I like the most. My watercolors are mostly from, my inspiration comes from nature. Costa Rica is a tropical country, and we live in a valley surrounded by mountains. But we also have very near the ocean. We have in one side the Pacific and in the other the Atlantic Ocean. So when I paint, I usually paint a lot of landscapes from nature. I love the sea and the greens. We have a really green country. But one of the things that I have been working on is trying to take the watercolor further. I would love to have more opportunities to do a non-traditional watercolor and to experiment a little bit more, because I feel always that all the events, they tell us the size of the paper and they like cut our wings to fly. I would love to have more opportunities to do different things. I will show you some of the things that I have done during these days. Just across the street from my house, I have a park. So my watercolors are mostly from my imagination. I'm not a plein air artist. More about feelings and imagination. We have this park, and I painted this watercolor after coming from the park. But I decided I didn't want only one watercolor, so I painted 9 small to one piece. This is when I'm entering the park, that it was in the summertime, in the dry season, so that's why the colors. But in that time, we have a lot of pink flowers and the pink trees. So I was keep walking and, you know, just to see the pink trees, that everything but was pink in the landscape. And here, then I found a lot of birds singing in the park. So it was like a symphony of sounds and colors. And then I went out with all those feelings in my heart. So this is like, for example, one of my watercolors.
This is fantastic, Silvia. Would this develop into bigger ones?
I think it's important to tell a story with the images also. This is a notebook that I bought in a notebook that I bought in China, and I love that you could go on and on. So I call it an artist calligraphy.
Uh-huh. Oh look. Wow. Yes.
I really love that this kind of book that they have in China.
Wow. Fantastic.
Cool.
I love it. Yes.
It's because I would love if we have more opportunities to do watercoloring, not only in the same size and the same shape. In these days, I have been working on Jupo paper, and one of the things that I really like is that with fire, I could give different shapes to the Jupo. So this is one.
You burn it.
Yes. You can even make even some holes in it. And the watercolor works great on this Jupo paper. Here I have another one.
Wow.
Yeah.
Never seen anybody do that before.
Wow. Wow.
I think as a watercolor artist, because they always in the competition, in the festivals, they always give us the size and the shape, and so we don't have the opportunity to do other things. This is one that I painted some years ago, but it was in a
Oh, look at this. Wow. Wow. What a beautiful portrait. How beautiful.
Wow.
Beautiful.
I'm always trying to find different ways.
And what about your glass? What about your glass? Yes.
Okay, I will bring one.
Because she's a glass artist. You have been doing glass for a long time, no?
Yes. This is one of the glass pieces that I really love, glass, because it's almost like the watercolor, that you could put glasses of different colors and shapes, and then you can get like the layers that we have in watercolor. And I wanted to show you, well, one of the things that I'm well known of is for my rooster, so I have
here. Ah, your rooster. Yes.
Wow.
Fantastic rooster. Yes, yes. Beautiful.
Here, another one.
Ah, yes. Even more abstract and more crazy. Crazy rooster. And you look so quiet, and so nobody would imagine that you're so wild, no? Is that so? Don't you agree with me?
Have more opportunities of like, for example, this this event that it's so nice that we can meet other artists and learn from other artists.
Exactly.
But also it'd be nice if we could have something out of the paper, like watercolor to the limits or something like that.
Yes.
Yes. Take the watercolor to the limits.
Yes. You certainly get out of the box.
I know, Angela, that you like to do these kind of things too.
Oh, I love it. And that's why when you come to Spain, we were going to do it together. Eh?
I already bought this, but I haven't tried yet.
Clean the house with it.
We will try it, Silvia. I will buy a roll of paper, and then we can practice it in Girona, in Barcelona or Girona. Listen, Silvia, it's so incredible. It's just... we're flowing of art and creativity. I love it. Thank you. Thank you so much for sharing. And No, I thought you were going to say something.
For giving me the opportunity to show you some of the things that I have been doing, and I hope to do many more.
I hope so. Never let anything stop you.
Maybe Stefan can do an event like this, but asking for non-traditional watercolor to see what it comes.
We'll see how it goes.
That is interesting. Interesting. Yes.
Mm.
How about now, Jorge Corpuna, who was going to be the first
Hola.
One. Hola, Jorge, ¿dónde estás? Que no te veo. Espera, que no te veo. Ah, mira. Hola, ¿cómo estás? ¿Tú hablas inglés, Jorge? ¿Hablas inglés?
No.
Bueno, pues mira, nos gustaría que ahora tú pudieras mostrarnos tu obra o hablar de lo que quieras. Y si hablas despacito en frases que sean cortas, yo te las puedo ir traduciendo, o quien sea, ¿vale? ¿Te parece?
Genial. Gracias, Ángel.
Jorge Corpuna comes from Perú. And from Cusco, or near Cusco. Mm. No, vives in Cusco, no? You live in Cusco. Cusco has mainly this Quechua culture, no? Yo quiero que me digas antes de empezar algo en Quechua, por favor. Tell me something in Quechua, because it's a lovely language. Very rich, Peru is so rich. Dime.
Imagina ya acuarelistas, guayfanaicuna. Hola, ¿cómo están, amigos? Hermanos y hermanas acuarelistas.
¿Cómo se diría?
Imaginaya acuarelistas Weig Banaikuna.
Ah, estupendo. Gracias.
Esa sería, hola, ¿cómo están hermanos y hermanas acuarelistas?
Sí, perfecto.
Un saludo.
Por favor, un saludo. He's given the salutation in Quechua. Because Peru is a very rich country, it has many languages. We want to see your work now. Enséñanos tu obra, por favor, que nos interesa mucho.
Oh, gracias. Bueno, aquí tengo un poco de lo que está haciendo últimamente. Son las que está publicando ahora último.
These are his latest works.
Paisajes cusqueños. Son paisajes del Valle Sagrado de los Incas.
Landscape from the Sacred Valley. By the Incas. Not too far, Cusco is not too far from Machu Picchu, so there is a sacred valley, they call it, valley full of temples and sacred places. Precioso.
Voy a acercar la cámara.
Sí.
Se pueden apreciar mejor.
Yes, you can see
closer.
Me gusta
en algunas ocasiones simplificar porque el mensaje sea un poco más directo. Algunas veces trabajo las luces, algunos detalles. Me encanta los azules y los verdes, cómo se manifiestan en el paisaje, en los arbustos, en los árboles.
Likes the grays and the greens, no? How they manifest in the landscapes, and he also likes to simplify so that the message is more direct.
Y un poco de las composiciones que está haciendo últimamente. Esta por acá.
Yes, his compositions, his latest compositions, yeah. And I love the green at the bottom. I like the green at the bottom. Me gusta mucho el verde de abajo y el de arriba aquí de la izquierda. Huh? I like the, those greens. But this simplification, allow me to say it, I've seen him even more simplified. Yo he visto con obra tuya que aún es más simplificada, que es prácticamente una línea del horizonte y poca cosa más, ¿no?
Ah, sí, bueno. Sí, me gusta un poco de usar los horizontes, que no tenga mucha información, que no sea muy que no distraiga mucho, ¿no? Que se llegue más rápido a la sensación del paisaje. Mm-hmm.
He sometimes when he does this, just a line of the horizon line, whether it's in the country with greens or he likes to give very little explanation so that the feeling of the landscape reaches the viewer.
He's amazing.
Wow.
Impacting, yes.
Gracias. Eso también me gusta un poco cómo se ve el efecto de... Perdón, con la cámara que tengo un poco de...
Se mueve un poco, ahí.
Sí, no, mantiene creo que mucho equilibrio esto. De...
Vale, ahora. Yes. Yes,
y un poco de textura también. Que voy experimentando en el camino.
Textures, yes, that he is experimenting. Now he's experimenting with things, you know.
Y bueno, algunas composiciones que también he estado trabajando con las luces.
He likes also to work with lights, with his lights. Look at the contrast of light here. Very, very dark against very, very light.
Las construcciones típicas aquí de Cusco son construcciones hechas de adobe, de barro, con fibras de paja.
¿De qué? ¿De?
Paja.
Ah, paja. Yes. These typical constructions made of adobe. Adobe, I think it's like mud, I'm not sure. And straw roofs.
Un poco este tiempo he estado tengo poco tiempo viviendo aquí en el Valle Sagrado y para mí ha sido muy gratificante todo lo que engloba la naturaleza, ¿no? me fui prácticamente para estar un poco más a gusto en mi trabajo y por los motivos que hay allá en el valle.
He hasn't been living in the Secret Valley for a long time, but he went there to just research and try to find, to be able to explore more and because there was more nature.
Angela, can you ask him, did he study under anybody or is he pretty much self-taught?
Mm-hmm. Me pregunta Andy si tú eres autodidacta o si has ido a algún tipo de formación, has hecho algún tipo de formación.
Sí, estudié acuarela aquí en Perú, en Arequipa. En Arequipa
en tenemos una escuela.
Exacto, sí. Tenemos una escuela de acuarela.
Y ahí estudiaste. Pues, son 5 años, ¿no? Cinco años.
Igual, ahí me conocí con Nicolás.
Ah.
Y comenzamos a pintar la acuarela, a conocer un poco más de la acuarela.
Andy, this is very interesting, Andy and the rest, everybody, because in Peru there is a university that has a college only for watercolor. It's 5 years of watercolor.
Wow.
And that's
wow.
Where he studied, in Arequipa, and that's where he met Nicolás and they started to paint together.
Wow, I'd love to see that sometime.
Yes. When they do the next festival, you must attend. Eh?
Yeah.
Nicolás, cuando hagáis el próximo festival de Perú, Andy tiene que venir. Eh?
Eso, sí.
Yes. Tenemos un minutito, Jorge. Tenemos un minutito. Sí, solo uno. Perdón.
Ah, oye, me queda poco. Bueno, quería mostrarles un poco más de esto. Como les comentaba, me gusta bastante los colores verdes. Las texturas. Este tiempo que he estado aquí En el valle he encontrado mucho motivo para trabajarlas. Me gusta trabajar los contrastes fuertes.
He likes to draw strong contrasts. In the valley, he has found a lot of inspiration. Exploring textures and the motifs, he has been very inspired by that.
Este es de Chinchero, en Cusco.
In Cusco, this is Cusco, the main city.
He has a lot of square paintings. Is that his preferred format? That's a little unusual too.
¿Te gusta el formato cuadrado por algo o es casualidad?
Sí, me gusta. Bueno, no es un formato convencional para empezar. Me gusta jugar en las composiciones. Me parece un poco más complicada, no sé, como un reto hacer un tipo de composiciones en formato cuadrado.
He likes these. It's like a challenge for him, and he likes that square format.
Gotcha.
So, muchas gracias, Jorge. Nos ha encantado.
No,
thank
gracias.
You so much. We've been delighted to watch him. No. Tal vez David, puedes continuar o quieres tú Nico. Nico, pero en inglés, ¿eh? Nico en inglés. Come on, Nico. Come on, speak. I help you.
Mute.
Habla, Nicolás, te toca.
Mute.
No tiene micrófono. No tienes voz.
He's mute, he's on mute. That's now say something. Oh.
Hola.
Sí.
Bueno, estoy muy a gusto de poder encontrar este espacio para poder compartir, hermanarnos dentro de la acuarela, ¿no? Eso, primeramente, muchas gracias.
He's very happy to be here, to be able to get together in the watercolor world.
Fabulous.
Bueno, a mí me ha tocado estos días que conocemos en un espacio muy particular para mí, muy confortable. No me encuentro en mi taller, no me encuentro en un estudio, estoy rodeado de la naturaleza, vivo en el campo, en la montaña, en Perú.
Uh-huh. So in these days he was going to be in Europe, but this lookout found him in Peru, in a very good space for him, because he's in the middle of nature and he doesn't have to be locked down in a flat. Or in
the
studio.
Mm-hmm.
Bueno, esto me ha sí, la naturaleza para mí es una motivación interesante para poder construir el conocimiento. Así ha sido siempre y lo creo todavía. Entonces, con la naturaleza me permite estar más sensible con este tipo de información.
So for him, nature has always provided him with a lot of information for to build or to connect with nature. He's very. Es que he perdido una parte de lo que has dicho, pero bueno, es igual.
Pero también es muy importante.
Que es muy importante. Me he perdido. Estás comiendo coca. Me distraes con la coca. Lo que sea.
Bueno, es el día a día siempre aquí.
¿Es coca? ¿Es coca?
Sí.
He's munching coke.
He needs to stay awake.
No, it's not cocaine.
No, I know.
mi producción se ha direccionado de un tiempo a esta parte hacia buscar estos elementos naturales para poder construir un lenguaje de la acuarela paralelo, no inferior ni superior, sencillamente paralelo a lo que puede darte una paleta y un papel, ¿no?
He has lately been using a lot the nature to build parallel ways to paint watercolor that is apart from just the colors and the and the brushes. And he will explain now why he's saying this. Y ahora nos vas a explicar por qué dices esto, ¿no?
Bueno, también me ha servido mucho el tiempo este para escribir. Me gusta, en mis tiempos, a veces que no pinto, me gusta escribir mucho sobre las cosas que siento cuando pienso en la acuarela, básicamente.
Not only is he painting a lot during this lockdown, but he's also writing. He likes to write what he feels, and this helps him.
Cuando me refiero a los elementos naturales y a la información que me da para la acuarela, me refiero, por ejemplo, en las pequeñas rocas que encuentro en el río. Bueno, no sé si se puede apreciar un poco las formas que tiene. Esta, por ejemplo, tiene una forma muy particular. Tiene como vetas, como túneles de agua, como caminos de agua.
Yes, he sees this rock like having ways of water. And when he finds a rock like that, there is a river there, when he finds a rock like that in the river, then he gets inspiration. ¿En qué sentido te inspira?
Para construir, bueno, traje algunas cosas para de casa.
Tenemos 3 minutitos, cariño.
Vale, muy breve, sí, está bien, muy breve. Como estas, por ejemplo, que son acuarelas sobre arena.
Oh. It's watercolor on sand.
Wow.
Yes.
Las líneas que se muestran.
Yes.
Sí.
Yeah. Yes.
Wow.
Bueno, son propias. Las hago en diferentes formatos. Bueno, he traído un
That's different de... formats. Look at all of these. ¿Esta también tiene arena?
Sí.
Yes, this is also with sand. Can you see the texture? It's difficult to see, but he likes to paint different things. It's also very creative. Look at that.
Watercolor?
Yes, on top there is watercolor. You see, he makes the texture with some sort of glue or something to make it stick, and then he paints on top, paints watercolor on top.
That's amazing. Esta otra, ¿no? Está intervenida con acuarela.
Ajá.
Wow.
Usas como un pegamento, ¿no? Para pegar la arena y después encima la gola, la acuarela se te aguanta.
Sí.
Buenísimo, Nicolás.
Me encanta mucho esta granulación, esta textura que tiene, porque es bastante intensa, es bastante propia de estos elementos. Me encanta mucho intentar representar esto en una acuarela.
He likes to represent what there is in this stone in a watercolor, trying to represent it. And this texture is what gives him a lot of pleasure.
Sí, porque la misma naturaleza tiene sus propias líneas, su propio lenguaje, su propia beta, su propia ranura. Entonces yo de alguna manera trato de usar estos elementos. El hecho de vivir en la naturaleza ahora me ha dado mucha información al respecto.
Yes, he was showing this tree trunk and these textures and the lines that the tree has, and that is what his contact with nature, his intense contact with nature lately, is giving him to explore further into his painting.
Nice.
Bueno, eso en conclusión, y también estoy leyendo algunos libros que me encantan mucho, que estoy algunos libros que tengo amigos que me han regalado para poder compartir. Perfección y fracaso de la técnica, es muy buena.
Perfección y fracaso de la técnica. It's perfection and failure of technique. Some friends gave him this book, Friedrich Georg Junger. Yes.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Yes. Thank you.
Es muy bueno, de verdad que me encanta mucho porque me ayuda un poco a destruir el normal de una técnica con un sentido, con un objetivo positivo, digamos, más allá de solo ser técnico.
He likes to break the technique, so to go further, to go beyond. And that's a lot of inspiration for him. Muchas gracias, Nico. Nos estaríamos muchas horas aquí, pero es que ya se nos ha acabado el tiempo. Qué pena.
Sí, sí,
yes. Mira, no, me suena hasta la alarma.
Wow.
Gracias.
Even my alarm is going off. Thank you so much, and we would spend hours here. David,
¿sí? ¿Cómo
puedes
está?
Ser el próximo? Buenas tardes, David. Adelante.
Bueno, yo soy egresado, yo estudiaba en una escuela de arte que es Carlos Pacaflor, Carequipa, Perú. Pertenezco a una asociación de la acuarela que es Luces del Sur. Muy contento.
He studied in a very important school in the south of Peru also. There's a lot of watercolors and a lot of information about watercolor, a lot of training, and belongs to an association, I cannot remember which, but also from the south of Peru.
Muy contento y feliz de hacer arte, porque desde un inicio mi trayectoria artística ha tenido una interrelación con el arte.
¿Vuélvelo a decir esto?
Que desde un inicio mi trayectoria artística ha tenido una interrelación con el arte.
His artistic trajectory has a relation with art.
Aprendí a liberarme de prejuicios, a ser libre. El arte, eso es que nos enseña a ser libres.
According to him, art teaches us to be free. Very good.
Dentro de esas disciplinas que hay en el arte, me inicié con la acuarela. De verdad, estoy muy contento.
He started with watercolor in his artistic path, and he's very happy about that.
Las etapas en las que he tenido ha sido desde una acuarela formal a una acuarela compleja y quedando algunas veces a una acuarela conceptual.
He has evolved from a very formal watercolor to more experimenting and conceptual watercolor. ¿Tienes alguna aquí para que las veamos?
Sí, ahora es que voy a pasar. Les voy a mostrar algunos bocetos con las cuales yo inicié o antes empezaba a hacer mis trabajos. Por ejemplo, este es un boceto.
¿Esto es como lo haces ahora o antes?
Esto es un boceto antes de iniciar alguna obra.
This is a sketch before starting a bigger painting.
Sí. Este es un estudio de una manzana.
Study for an apple. Wow. I could have almost eaten it. Casi nos la podemos comer.
Gracias. Es un objeto de la serie El Solista.
¿Cómo?
El Solista. Tengo un proyecto. El Solista es un proyecto acerca de sobre la ecología y la talación de árboles.
He has a project about ecology and why the tree cutting, and so he's calling this The Soloist.
Oh, wow, I love it.
Les voy a mostrar lo que tengo acá. ¿Vale? En el taller que preparé. Este es un homenaje a mi madre.
Enfoca un poco más de lejos, que lo veamos un poco más de lejos, que veamos la obra entera.
Ya, está bien ahí ahora.
Bájalo un poco, bájalo. Ahora. Yes, this is a homage to his mother. Qué bonita.
Sí. Gracias.
Preciosa.
Este es un paisaje de Moquegua.
A landscape from Moquegua.
Sí. Y acá tengo este es un paisaje de Puno.
Landscape Lampa. Of Puno.
Voy a hacer un recorrido de una acuarela formal a la acuarela fuera de lo convencional. Esto es un paisaje de Yuramayo.
Yes. This is, he's going to guide us through the process of a formal watercolor to the non-formal or more abstract.
Este es una iglesia de, el, Valle de los Volcanes.
Mm-hmm. This is a church from the Valley of the Volcano.
Sí.
Sí.
Este es un bodegón.
Still life.
Sí, wow. Es un bodegón. Mm-hmm. Sí. Es un bodegón.
Me encanta.
Y es así. Gracias. Y es así como esta que empiezo con un homenaje a mis padres que son de Puno. Un homenaje mm-hmm. de la serie con la que empezó la serie de No te muevas. ¿No? Es el departamento de Puno, la parte sur, bueno, ¿no? Con algunas vivencias de lo que ellos viven, ¿no?
Mm-hmm. This is more conceptual art, and from his parents who live in Puno, it means don't move. ¿Y este es último del pasaporte?
Sí, y este es un homenaje a mi padre, este es la libreta militar de mi papá.
It's the military book of his father. It's a homage. Qué interesante todo.
Gracias. Y este es un político. Este es un político que cumplía 50 años una irrigación donde empezaron así en un desierto y después empezaron a trabajar.
Claro. This is a politic of some water watering of in a deserted zone, and they started working there and he did a series of paintings.
Claro, que empiezan y es así que ahora ellos disfrutan del verdor y del esfuerzo que han hecho para hacerlo un grandes campos de cultivo.
And now it's become a great field of crops.
Bueno, ahora estoy pintando también este bote, esta marina.
Uh-huh.
Y también mostrarles que a veces este es de la serie Desgraciados.
How do you translate Desgraciados? Of the unlucky ones or whatever. Oye, David, qué precioso, nos encanta. Pero ya tenemos que pasar al próximo. A ver, enséñanos este último. This is the last
one. Este es mi familia.
His family.
Este es mi familia.
Yes.
Sí. Es, bueno, este es lo último que estoy pintando.
And this is what he's painting at the moment. Wow. Fabulous, fabulous works. Thank you. Thank you. And now we have to move. Muchas gracias, David. We have to move to Tere. She asked to be the last one. So, Tere Lojero, it's your turn.
Hi, how are you, everyone? I want to thank for this invitation. Thank you, Stefan. Thank you, Andy. Thank you, everyone, for being here with me. My name, as you said, is Tere Lojero. I'm from Mexico. I'm an architect. But nowadays, yes, I'm an architect. Because there are a lot of architects in this world. So nowadays, I'm completely devoted to watercolor. Watercolor is my passion. And also landscape and cities. I start always my work with some sketches, taking photos. Sometimes I can work on the spot, or sometimes I can only take the photo I took and then started the work. I want to show you sometimes, this is my notebook. You can see I have a lot to write, but also when I have some time, I started with my pen, only with my pen, to do my sketches.
Value sketches, yes.
Yes, just value sketches.
Is that Madrid? That is Madrid.
Yeah, that's Madrid, and this is Toledo.
Oh, okay.
You can see this. You can see this sketch. This was made in South Africa. And if you can see there, the painting is already done. You can see.
Okay. Yes.
Wow.
This is the sketch.
Mm-hmm. The sketch to the painting.
Wow, big painting to make.
Yeah.
Remarkable.
Yes, enormous.
Yeah. And I like to, you know, I like to work also with sketches like that, only in pen, but also with some watercolor sketches like this.
Ah, yes. Yes.
This is Mexico. The this one is Valle de Bravo, and this one is Cuernavaca in Mexico. And you can see here Valle de Bravo also, and you can see all this. These sketches are very useful for me because I can see the perspective, which I am very interested in showing how street, how the buildings are moving, and you can pass the 3D, the 3D to our paintings. And I want to show you how I can do this then.
Oh,
and like Sylvia, I like.
Oh, look at that. Look at that.
Trying to show the, I mean, all the perspective. And you can see this. This is watercolor made in Ecuador, in Quito. And this is El Carmen. That's a monastery in Mexico. This is only the drawing. And finally, this one.
Wow.
This is Fabriano.
No, this is Brussels. Oh, this is
beautiful.
What I like to do is to show perspective. And I like color. I like color, maybe because in my culture, color is everywhere. Everywhere you go, you can see color. You see, Prague, this is Prague.
Prague, yes.
And sometimes when painters paint Prague, it's very, very dark. But I don't like that. I like color. That's why I'm trying to show the colors that I'm watching and trying to express myself and to show how I see this cityscape or landscape to many people. And also, I try to keep it simple.
Oh, look at that.
Wow.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah, to keep it simple, just to give the impression of a place where it is not very defined. It is also with a lot of color. It's a Mexican house in a Mexican town. There are a lot of them. But I also like to capture moments in the life. This is another town from Mexico, and I like to keep it simple. With some darks, with color, and with some details. I like to do that. I want to show you a watercolor. Well, first, I want to show you my palette. This is my palette, and this is the color that I mostly use when I'm painting. The most important, and my brushes.
Wow.
And then I want to show you how I like to keep this simple. This is a watercolor in 2 steps. What you can see here is just the first layer.
Yes.
And then from the first layer, I added some shadows. And I try that people can see things that are there, but not with so much detail. And then the third step is the detail. Well, just wait for me because something happening here. And this is with the detail, but I'm doing something wrong. Can you see?
Fabulous.
Yes.
Just very, very interesting to see the step by step. Very, very interesting.
Yeah. And I like to do this kind of watercolors. These are 15 minutes on the spot.
Wow.
And trying to give impression of things that are there, but not with so much detail. Detail.
I remember in Bulgaria you did those beautiful paintings of the boats and strong impression.
Yeah. When I'm painting boats, I like to give, well, let me show you this one. I think I have it in reality. These are boats.
Yes.
And if you can see, there is a big layer of color in the background, but when you see the details, are only spots. There are nothing there.
Yeah.
But
exactly.
When you go back, it's like the impressionist, no? Impressionistic.
Yes.
And that's what I want to do. And I want to show you another painting. That's Venice.
Wow.
And I want to be here closer. And you can see the spots.
Yes.
Shape. Okay.
Oi, querida.
I'm sorry. And this time is.
Yes, one
more thing. Can I say something? Something quick?
Of course.
Yes. I think that these times, these coronavirus times, has made us to think. To think that we have to create a community, a big artist community. And that's what I'm working on in the IWS project, the Pan American project. And all these 20 countries are working to present to the world an online exhibition. Thank you.
Wow.
Thank you so much,
wow.
Didi. Apart
fantastic.
From an excellent painter, you're a great organizer. Thank you.
Fantastic. Fantastic. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Also, the group, everyone. Angela, thank you very much for the hosting. Can I thank everyone from our team here and from the viewers that are watching the show. Just love to thank you for your time, for your energy, and for your passion in watercolor. Without people and artists like yourselves, this just would not happen. I'm sure everyone watching at home is just amazed with the experience and just fantastic artistry that you all have shown in your works. So can I please thank each of you, Jorge, Silvia, Nicholas, David, also Cess, Andy, and Angela. Thank you very much for coming along. Have I missed anyone? I hope I haven't missed anyone.
We had something ready for you.
Yeah,
oh, you
I
did.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
And as we always say at the end of this show.
Go with
the flow. I thought
arriba,
it might catch on.
Abajo, adentro,
thank you.
Adentro.
See you all. Thank you.